I see you calling. I didn't wanna leave you like that. It's 5 in the morning. Yeah, I'm currently waiting for lunch. The time now is like 4:30. Yeah, at this point my sleep schedule is so screwed up that like, yeah, this is about the normal time that I will have lunch. I just got KFC from Deliveroo cause I felt like I should treat myself for the amount of coding that I'm gonna be doing this weekend. Yeah, you guys should never pay this much for KFC. I paid $15.50 for a 2-piece chicken meal. That's ridiculous. I am working on this software development project called Orbital. The second milestone is due on Monday. Today is Saturday, and since I last filmed that video where I mentioned that I have no time left, I have not done anything. Yeah, so this weekend I'm just gonna lock myself in my room and code. Oh my god, they just delayed the order to like 5 p.m. What the hell? People are already having dinner, but my lunch is not even here yet. I haven't even had breakfast thinking about it. So this is the current screen that I'm working on right now. The other day I calculated, I spent a total of 17 hours trying to deploy the website because it was my first time deploying, and there were so many issues. KFC has arrived. I'm gonna be watching some MKBHD videos while I eat. Coding for a couple of hours now, and I have made some progress. For context, this app is basically an order collection website for you to collate orders with your friends. So right now I'm able to click on the order, and then it brings me to this page where I can view the details. It generates like a 6-digit code, and also I have linked up the editing and deleting routes. So yeah, I also added this page where you can search for an order. Let me just enter hi YouTube, and obviously it shouldn't work. Yeah. So I see my friend Ramos online on Discord right now, and he's actually also doing Orbital, so I'm gonna check with him how he's doing.
Hello.
Yo. Hey, how's your progress?
Finish for Master
2. What the? So fast, dude. That's not fair. The time now is 6:18 a.m. I'm not sure if you can hear the bird chirping. So what I've created since my last update at 1:30 a.m. is you can finally add orders to the OpenSEO. So I can type chicken McNuggets, and then I want some spicy sauce, and I can submit the order, and it takes a while. Yay! Woohoo! It's added, so I can see my name and my order, and under all orders it also appears. So that's all the features I'm gonna do for this stage, and I think I'm gonna sleep now. So good night, guys, or rather good morning, and I'll see you in the next part of the vlog. Hi guys, today I'm with Milton and we are at Wild Wet. We both actually live pretty near here, like we live in Pasir Ris, so it's kind of like our neighborhood playground. I know most people probably won't come to Wild Wet because it's like freaking in the other end of Singapore, but yeah, we've actually been playing for a while already. This is my favorite, the Mad Slides. At the end right, it almost feels like you gotta flip.
Yeah.
I'm not kidding.
You must hold it quite hard. So there's Joel, you all can see him. He's going up. A bit too cinematically, but it's actually very tiring because you're climbing like a few good stories.
I think the best part about coming to Wild Wet now is that you can walk around without your mask, which feels damn weird. If you want to experience walking around without a mask, maybe you should come to Wild Wet.
Not sure that's the best promo.
So there's this ride called the Torpedo. And basically it's like a freaking trap door that just opens up. You're just standing on the floor and then the floor just opens up and then you drop. I've taken the ride like 4 or 5 times, but I'm still damn scared each time I take it. This little playground here is my childhood. Like, can you imagine baby Joel climbing up these like nets and stuff, and then trying to spray other people?
Or rather my dad, because I'm the only child, you know, so quite sad. I only play with my dad, but yeah.
So we are here at Sim Lim Square. And what's the time now?
4:45.
And what meal are we having?
Breakfast.
I think two of us are the most degen people in the world. I'm not even kidding. Like, straight up, there are some days that we both wake up at 5. And then we have
we have our breakfast at 6 p.m.
So we're here at this pretty famous place. At least I think it's pretty famous. Wei Shan recommended it to me. And I found a Sefli article on it. So it's this called, place called Taste Good. And they have this pretty famous salted egg chicken. Mmm, it's damn creamy.
It's very creamy. It's very flavorful. The chicken is like very tender.
There's a queue to enter the keyboard shop. Yeah, so recently I've been kind of falling down the keyboard rabbit hole. Actually it started with you, like, very first. Because Raymond's got a new keyboard. Then I started researching and like following some TikTok keyboard accounts. And then the ASMR was too good. Yeah, here I am trying to find a new keyboard.
Oh really?
To be honest, this feels more like the red one.
You see like how small and bold it is.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, it's possible. The party software. Wow.
So unfortunately they sold out of the Mac version of the keyboard. So they said they only had like 5 units in the last year. Which is crazy lah, what the hell. So I'm going home empty-handed today. So sad. Yeah, gotta wait. I don't know who knows how long to get my ASMR fixed.
Yeah, there's only one shop in all of Singapore that sells this kind of keyboards. After touching those keyboards just now, touching any other keyboard doesn't feel the same.
Yeah, honestly, every other keyboard feels damn shit now. It really be a rabbit hole, man. So I'm back home now and I actually went online to do some research and I managed to find the exact keyboard that I wanted. And I went ahead to place an order already. So hopefully it arrives soon. Super excited to replace my current keyboard. My current keyboard is the N Pro 2. This keyboard works, but it really doesn't come close to how the keyboard that I tried just now felt. I think getting that keyboard might make me more productive in my work, because I would actually enjoy typing. So thank you so much for watching whatever this vlog was. If you enjoyed it, do subscribe to my channel. I'm hoping to hit 3,000 subscribers before my birthday in September. And if you also happen to be into keyboards, do leave a comment down below saying what your favorite keyboard is, or you'd like to know. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.